Hi, welcome to my Procreate Beginner Series. Today, we're going to learn about how to create a new canvas in Procreate and understand the parameters of different canvas sizes. First, go to the main interface. Click on the top right. You can see a canvas size menu. These are all system-built canvas sizes. Let's look at some canvas size parameters that I use frequently. Screen size. This is a size that I use very often. Let's take a look. It's 1668 × 2388 pixels. The default print size is 32 × 46 centimeters. DPI is 132. The default maximum number of layers is 164. Now let's look at other sizes. Square, 2048 × 2048. This is also a very convenient size for daily use. Similarly, the DPI is 132. The printable size is 39 × 39 centimeters. The default maximum number of layers is 156. What we are seeing now, most of the RGB and daily use are 132 DPI. If you want to use it as a printable image, it's best to choose the one marked as, like the CMYK 3000 × 3000 PX. Let's take a look at its parameters. 7.3000. The printable size is 25 × 25 centimeters. DPI is 300. Now, let's see its layer count. Generally speaking, for an illustration of medium difficulty, I usually use between 50 to 70 layers. So a layer count within 70 is very useful. We are now all of the size that we're no longer essentially that you can reach without. And we can create a new canvas that suits your needs. Click this small icon. Let's assume we want to set it to 2048 × 2048 pixels. Set the DPI to 150. Then the default maximum layer count is 156. In this way, you've created your own unique canvas. What you need to note is if you choose the canvas size at the beginning, avoid copying the image onto a new canvas later on, as this will reduce image quality. For example, this picture, I drew it on a 2388 × 1668 canvas. The image is very clear. The DPI is 132. You can see that I only used 20 layers. The default maximum layer count is 164, so 50 to 70 layers are very useful. When I copy the image to a 2048 × 2048 canvas, although the DPI is also 132, the image becomes blurry. So try to decide on the image size you want to use at the beginning to avoid loss of image quality later on. I hope today's video has been helpful to you. I'll see you next time.